Today, I'll be showing you the recipe for zucchini curry, a fusion of Indian and Thai cuisine, for which we will need 2 tablespoons ginger garlic paste, 8 to 10 cut curry leaves, 1 tablespoon kitchen king masala, 2 medium onions finely cut, 1/2 cup shredded coconut frozen, and all Indian spices, 1 tablespoon cumin seeds, 1 teaspoon turmeric powder, 1 tablespoon garam masala, 1 tablespoon dhania powder, 1 to 2 tablespoon of red chili powder, and 1 to 2 tablespoon of salt, 1 can of coconut milk, 1 cup of milk, either whole milk or 2%, whatever you like, 5 medium zucchini cut into 1 inch pieces. Now this recipe is flexible and you can make it according to the ingredients that you have on your hand. If you have only coconut milk, then use 2 cans of coconut milk for this recipe. And if you have just shredded coconut, then use 1 cup of shredded coconut and 2.5 cup of milk. Or else, if you have all the ingredients like I am showing you in this recipe today, you should be using 1/2 cup of shredded coconut, 1 can of coconut milk, and 1 cup of milk. That was the list of the ingredients. Now let's start making this dish. For this, add 3 tablespoons of oil in a heated pan. Add some cumin seeds. Let it splutter, and then we'll be adding the ginger garlic paste into it. And after this, ideally you should be adding curry leaves, but I forgot and I'm adding it after onion, which is also fine. Now add your onion, stir it and keep it on medium heat and let it cook till it is slightly brown in color. Now add the shredded coconut, stir it and let it cook for around 3 to 4 minutes, and then we'll be adding all the spices. First, turmeric powder, then red chili powder, then garam masala, kitchen king masala, and dhania powder. Now it's time to add coconut milk and milk. I'm using 2% milk, and I think that should be good. Stir it and cook it for 3 to 4 minutes. Then we should be adding zucchini. And now it's time to add salt, our final ingredient. Just stir it once and cover it and cook it on medium heat. Keep checking in between. Be careful, it might be hot. Well, it has been 5 minutes now, and if you like crunchy flavor, it's done. But we really like well-cooked zucchini, so I'll be cooking for 5 minutes more. It looks done for me now. We should garnish it with some cilantro and serve it with plain rice and tortilla chips. Thanks for watching my video. Bye bye.